हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ कुंजल मेहता फ्रॉम एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, अहमदाबाद. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंडक्ट दिस लेक्चर ऑन टीटीएल लॉजिक फैमिली. तो लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द ट्रांजिस्टर ट्रांजिस्टर लॉजिक. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द लॉजिक फैमिली, इट इज़ नेसेसरी टू अंडरस्टैंड द बेसिक्स फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ आईसीज. व्हाट इज आईसी? इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट्स. तो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द टी टी एल, लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द डिफरेंट इंटीग्रेशन लेवल्स. वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन? द डिफरेंट गेट्स और कंपोनेंट्स आर फैब्रिकेटेड ऑन अ सिंगल चिप, राइट? द फर्स्ट टाइप इज एस एस आई, स्मॉल स्केल इंटीग्रेशन, मीडियम स्केल इंटीग्रेशन, नेक्स्ट लार्ज स्केल इंटीग्रेशन, नेक्स्ट वेरी लार्ज स्केल इंटीग्रेशन, नेक्स्ट अल्ट्रा लार्ज स्केल इंटीग्रेशन. सो दीज आर द टाइप बेस्ड ऑन द नंबर ऑफ कंपोनेंट्स आर फेब्रिकेटेड ऑन अ सिंगल चिप. इन एस एस आई वी कैन फेब्रिकेट 10, मोर देन 10 गेट्स ऑन अ सिंगल चिप. इन एम एस आई वी कैन फेब्रिकेट 100 ऑफ गेट्स ऑन अ सिंगल चिप. इन लार्ज स्केल इंटीग्रेशन थाउजेंड्स ऑफ गेट्स मीन्स कंपोनेंट्स कैन बी फेब्रिकेटेड ऑन अ सिंगल चिप. Very large scale, 10,000 gates can be fabricated on a single chip. And similarly, ultra large scale integration, 100K gates can be fabricated on a single chip. Introduction of logic family. So students, different ICs can make a logic family. So this is the definition of logic family. It is the set of chips. First of all, we understand the chips and integrated circuits, and then what is logic family? Logic families are the sets of chips, okay? And they have the different parameters. They can be different and they can be varied. They can be identified by different parameters like speed, power consumptions, cost, voltage and current levels. IC digital logic families, which are the types? Now come to the point of the types of logic families. Diode logic, DTL, that means diode transistor logic, RTL, it's the full form, resistor transistor logic. We will study about the TTL. So in this lecture, transistor transistor logic, ECL, emitter coupled logic, MOS, metal oxide semiconductor, and CMOS, complementary metal oxide semiconductor. We have previously explained and understood about this. Then in this lecture, we will study about the TTL construction and circuit and working of the transistor-transistor logic. Now come to the point of the features of the TTL. How can you identify the TTL logic family? We all know the logic family or logical waveform, that is the square wave. It will have the two types of this levels, low level and high level. One is low level and another is high level. The logic level of TTL, low level, that will be 0 to 0.2 volt, and high logic level of the TTL, that is, will be 5 volt. Typical fan out of TTL is equal to 10. Basic TTL device draws the power of almost 10 millivolt. The average propagation delay will be 9 nanosecond, and the noise margin of TTL will be 0.4 volt. So these are the features of TTL. Now the main application of the TTL, we can draw or realize NAND gate structure, two input NAND gate from the construction of the TTL. This is the main transistor logic circuit, which will have the four transistors. Look at this. Before drawing this circuit, dear students, it will look like complex circuit, but actually the circuit is very interesting, which will have the four transistors Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. two inputs A and B, one output that is denoted by Y. Plus 5 volt supply is connected here and few resistors are connected. So according to the circuit, it consists resistor, diode and transistors. It has two input and one output, one supply voltage 5 volt, okay. Q1 transistor has two emitters. Look at this. This is the most important point to remember. The Q1 is the transistor which will have the two emitter with arrows, two emitter terminals, right? That means these are NPN transistors and Q1 which will have two emitter terminals. That's why we can apply the two inputs here, A and B. And we can realize at the end, this is the NAND gate, okay? Two input TTL NAND gate. So this is the circuit of two input TTL NAND gate. This is the equivalent circuit of two input NAND gate. Only for understanding, these are the two inputs. We are using the three diodes and one resistor to represent the Q1 transistor. And this is the Q2 transistor. The output of Q1 transistor is applied to the Q2 transistor. Also in the main circuit, the collector is connected to the base of Q2, right? In equivalent circuit, if both inputs are 0, 0, 0, that means A and B both are low, or any one of the low, that means that corresponding diode will conduct because cathode is connected with the input, right? And that diode will conduct and due to that 5 volt will be utilized for D4. And D4 will be forward biased. So this equivalent circuit is only for understanding. Okay, this is the Q1 equivalent circuit and then after Q2 is connected. We will understand the operation. I will explain the operation and working of two input TTL NAND gate and its truth table from this main circuit, right? Now, for any of the two input gate, what do you think? You will think that there will be two inputs. Ma'am, there are two inputs, possible combinations are four. So, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. Possible combinations can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So, initial three possible combinations, we can say that any of the input is 0. Right? So, let's continue with the cases of operation and truth table. Operation of the circuit and truth table. So, very first I will explain the case 1. Dear students, it is very simple to understand the operation with the help of NAND gate truth table. Because it is finally the realization of NAND gate. So, this is the truth table of 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So, I am considering these three cases first in which any one of the input is low. So, come to the main circuit. This one. If both inputs are low or any one of the input is low, then this is the case 1. A and B both low or either A or B low. At that time, base emitter junction of Q1 will be forward biased according to the equivalent circuit, right, that I have explained in previous PPT. The base of Q1 is 0.7. This reduces the base of Q2. So, Q2 will be open. So, you can understand the Q2 will be cut off. That means Q2 cuts off, it will be open switch. Q2 will be in off condition. If Q2 will be off condition, if it is open, so there will be no connection with Q4, right? So Q4 will be off and according to that Q4 will be off, right? If Q2 is open, your Q4 will be open. So continue with the case 1. Q3 is operating a meter follower, and finally output Y will be 1, because again come to the main circuit. See this, if both inputs are low or any one of the input is low, base will be 0.7 and collector, no base, collector is connected to the Q2 base, Q2 will be open, so connection will be cut off from Q4, so Q4 will be open, so 5 volt will be applied to the Q3 and Q3 will be on. If Q3 will be on and the diode will be forward biased, and final output Y is equal to 1. Okay, so according to this case 1, as Q3 is operating ammeter follower mode, output Y will be pulled up to high voltage Y equal to 1. Now continue with the case 4 of truth table. Truth table case 4, but for working you can directly consider the case 2. If both inputs are high, means 1 1, okay, A and B both high, then what will happen? If both inputs are high, then both diodes D2 and D3 will be reverse biased. In equivalent circuit we have seen two inputs are applied to this D2 and D3, right? If both are 1 1, both are applied to the cathode, so D2 and D3 will be reverse biased. So in case 2, D2, D3 will be reverse biased, therefore D4 will be forward biased. In main circuit, base is supplied to transistor Q2. Current is supplied to transistor Q2 and Q1 is off. Q2 conducts so that Q2 will be on and Q3 will be off. Q4 goes into the saturation. In previous case, Q4 off and Q3 on. In this case, Q3 off and Q4 goes into the saturation. So final output Y will be pulled down to low and Y equal to 0. So dear students, always try to understand the cases of operation from this main circuit. If Q3 on and Q4 off, at that time Y equal to 1, but when Q3 off for case 2, when both inputs are high, at that time Q3 goes into the saturation because Q4 on, and according to that Y equal to 0. Q3 off and Q4 goes into the saturation, so output voltage Y will be 0. Thus you can draw the truth table according to the inputs. If both inputs are 0, 0, 0, 1 and 1, 0, Y equal to 1, 1, 1. And if both inputs are 1, 1 high, then Y equal to 0. So finally we can understand this is the working is simply of NAND gate. So this is the main circuit or equivalent circuit is the equivalent or realization of NAND gate truth table. So finally the output is 1, 1, 1 and 0 for different combination of the inputs in this given sequence. Now let's continue with the advantages and disadvantages of TTL. TTL logic family is used for high speed. It is available in all commercial and military versions. Low cost, it is one of the advantage. Moderate packaging density, these are the advantages of TTL. Now let's discuss about the disadvantages. High power consumption, it requires high power dissipation or consumption, right? Poor noise margin, and it cannot handle very high noise, and less fan out than CMOS. If you will compare with the CMOS, TTL will have the less fan out. Thank you.